Look at these signs.
Starting another war, which we don't need. And of course, any peace negotiation is the end of hostilities, but any kind of peace negotiation is going to involve give and take. And so this is part of the process. I wish people would stop arguing and start trying to cooperate in some kind of dialogue. Some sense. It's common sense. I think that's what the Patriots back in 1776 were doing. They were trying to get some dialogue with England. England wouldn't listen. So I think I just hope that somebody listens and common sense prevails.
So we're standing outside, you know, Lisa Bonick's office.
Yes.
She's come out against the Iran deal, saying, you know, it's, well, I don't know exactly what she said, but I know the gist of it is that, you know, this doesn't last long enough, it's very temporary, inspections aren't rigorous enough, and so on and so forth, not a good deal. You know, what do you say to that?
Well, it's, so far it's the best deal that's been gotten. So, you know, when you were battling a forest fire in Colorado, you debate about the best way of fighting that fire, you go out there and do the best you can. And so I think that's what's going on now. And I welcome her criticisms. I think she should be involved. Perhaps she has some really good ideas. But get involved in the process. Just don't try to stop it for political gain. That's my piece.
And you know, Senator Chuck Schumer also came out against the deal. You know, he's one of the most influential, you know, Democratic leaders right now. Was that, how do you feel about his position on it?
I wish he would reconsider. I think it should be a work in process, progress. You know, I don't know what the negotiations are, but keep hacking away. So that's my opinion, and who's going to listen to me? Maybe, you know, some people will turn on the radio and hear my point of view.
Sorry. Okay? Oh, my technology has...
Bill, why did you come down here to rally on behalf of...
Because I think we're risking war if we don't continue to practice diplomacy. It's as simple as that. We've been in diplomatic negotiation with Iran now for several years. I think it has to continue until it's resolved. If we don't, we cut it off, there's always going to be war.
They do.
So anyway, that's the
the support for these accords has been overwhelming. There's a public letter by 29, a whole lot of outstanding scientists. Some of them, yes, thank you, Nobel Prize winners, who are praising the stringency of the agreement and the unprecedented vigor of the inspection arrangements. Now, one of the things that our Senator Schumer has questioned is the inspection arrangements, that they really are draconian. And Iran has submitted to a great deal of humiliation. It wouldn't be reasonable to ask for any more. There's a public letter by former U.S. diplomats endorsing the agreement unambiguously, and there's dozens of retired admirals and generals who have come out and said this is the best course to take with Iran, not going to war. It's also a mindset that calls a pro-war stance strong and decisive, and calls work for peace weak and wishy-washy. There's a sign here somewhere that kind of reminds us that it takes at least as much effort, training, courage, determination to wage peace as it does to wage war. One other thing that's important to know is that Iran is a signatory to a nuclear non-proliferation treaty. That kind of thing. But what's significant is that the agreements limit enrichment of uranium in Iran to 2.37%, which is what's needed for many of the medical applications and some of the energy applications that Iran has been trying to do. Addresses to know that people signing petitions live in their district. Okay. Okay, so this will circulate, and meanwhile, does anybody have any questions?
Have you spoken to the congresswoman yet about this?
No, we have called the office and let them know that we will be coming by on topic, but we have not spoken with her yet. I don't need to apologize.
Mary Ellen. Yes. Like
mentioned, the great number of rabbis came out in favor of this. 300. Okay, good point. 300 American rabbis have come out in favor, and much of the Jewish community is in favor. Many leaders in Israel, I've heard, are in favor of the Iran treaty. It's just a few. I'm not going to use any adjectives. I'll just say that the opposition to the treaty is small.
Who else wants to sign?
But we do need to make sure that Congress, both the House and the Senate, approve the treaty agreements when they come up for a vote.
I'm Rob Fountain, I'm the photographer.
And that has to be done by September 7th.
Ladies over here.
Yeah, this is great coverage. I love it.
Yep, there's a lot.
Who else?
Just slide over here. They could grab these ladies over here. Got a photo.
Any other questions?
Or any other
observations?
We want to support the agreement. Should we write that down here?
R-I-D.
Support the
R-I-T-A.
Capital G. You guys want to sign?
Okay.
Who else?
Good thing you spoke.
Thank you.
I can get
your name. I guess you would sign it too.
I did sign. Big, just like
John Hancock.
John Hancock. Make it big.
Jan Hancock.
Jane Gore. Chase.
Jane Gore?
Yes.
All right, thanks.
Just retired from working at the Peace Corps, so you know where I come from.
All right.
Okay. Who's next?
I'll be next. I got my own.
The Peace Corps budget for 1 year was one day in Afghanistan for the U.S. government. That was the comparison on the budget.
Non-proliferation movement among nations to stop new countries from acquiring nukes and to get countries that do have them to diminish their stockpiles and not to make more. Iran is a leader in that movement.